Since it debuted in 1990, the Lexus ES has accounted for 25% of the company's global sales. And with that in mind, it invited press from around the world to drive this ES here in Oregon, and that included Russia, which accounts for the temporary no smoking signs that we found in the vehicles. As for the ES, yes, it's a step up from the fifth generation. Yes, it should have leather seats in the base. And yes, I really like the electric power steering, although some commented they found it just a bit light. Now remember, the demographic starts at about 63 years old, but there's enough bells and whistles to keep it interesting. And I think that loyal customers will be happy, and who knows, they might even attract a few new ones into the showroom. Before we go, make sure you check us out at motoringtv.com. We want to hear from you. Get in on the conversation by joining us on Facebook for the Total Motoring Experience. That's it for now. We'll see you next time out as we continue to bring you more stories about cars and the people who drive them.
That tank was absolutely bleeping unreal. I mean, the guy had taken a military tank, lopped the gun off, cut the top deck off, put in scaffolding so that these unsuspecting idiots that paid to go on a ride could hold on to a steel bar as this maniac went romping up and down hills.